this time with a word of prayer. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you once again for this beautiful day. Lord Father, we thank you for blessing us with this new day. Thank you for the breath of life for today. Thank you for the many blessings that you have blessed us with, Father God. And today, as we gather together to worship you and to praise you and honor you, Father God, we come before your presence and we ask you, Lord, to cleanse us by your precious blood, Lord Jesus. And the things that we may have done over the week that is not right before you, Father God, we ask you to forgive us, Father God. And today we ask your Holy Spirit, Lord, to come into our midst, Lord, and minister to each and every one of us here today, Lord, Father God. And we ask you to speak to us through your Holy Spirit and help us to give your worship from our heart. That will bring glory to your name. And we commit this time to you and commit the rest of the day to you. And we ask all these things in the wonderful and the blessed name of our Lord and Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Yeah. Yeshua. of great trial, of famine and darkness and sorrow. We are the voice in the desert crying, prepare the way of the Lord. Behold, He comes riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice. It's the era to believe, and out of Zion here salvation comes. These are the days of Ezekiel, the tribals becoming as flesh. And these are the days of the servant David, rebuilding the temples. And these are the days of the harvest, the fields are white in the world. And these are the laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord. Behold, He comes riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet's call, lift your voice. It's the era of Jubilee, and out of science, yes, salvation come. Behold, He come, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet's call, lift your voice. It's the era of Jubilee, and out of science, yes, salvation.
There's no good like Jehovah. 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 Behold, He comes riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice. Here as you believe, and not as science, is salvation come. Behold, He comes riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet's call, lift your voice. It's the era of Jubilee, and not as science, is salvation come. Behold, He comes riding on the cloud, shining like the sun. At the trumpet calls, lift your voice. It's the era of Jubilee, and not of science, is salvation
come. Open the eyes of my heart. Prof. Kijie, welcome to the house of God. We worship the Lord. Now we just want to read the Bible, give you a sermon today. The word of God today is Ephesians chapter 1, verse 17 to 18. We just want to read. I keep asking that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that you may know him better. Verse 18, I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope, the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people. Let's pray together. Our loving Father, thank you so much. You always good for us, Lord. Lord, every moment you give us this grace and love all the time. No matter who we are, no matter what we do, Lord, you are good God all the time. You are greater than our sins. So every time we commit sin and we can come to you and confess you in the name of Jesus, you forgive our old sin and you are giving us the chance again and again. Thank you so much for this, Lord. Now we gather in spiritual place. We want to worship you and want to listen to the word of God. Spirit of wisdom and understanding and revelation that come to our heart and let us understand what you want to tell us today. Lord, thank you. In this moment is yours. We give you glory and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Okay. This Ephesians telling you about who you are at the first moment. And after that, what kind of blessing we have. Every spiritual blessing in the heavenly realm, he wants to tell us. So we know that who we are. We beloved by God. Amen. So we thank you. We thank God for that all the time. And also, and after that, he start to giving thanks to our God what you are, the Ephesian people. This spiritually, you and me. So he wants to tell us today. Yeah. Thank God for that all the time. I thank God also for our Lomawai and Naceva church. Their struggle in all your life is not easy in this situation. We come together. But I heard something what you've done in your life and what you were fighting for our God in your life. That's why I thank God for that too. We have a hope. We have a love. We have faith in Jesus Christ. Amen? Yeah. That's why we thank God for that, the same like Paul. Today, start with this prayer. Two things. Last time I told you that may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation so we know better about our God. Amen? We have to know about God more and more. I told you. The eyes of your heart may be enlightened. Enlightened means open. We sing all the time, say, open the eyes of my heart, Lord. Open the eyes of my heart. Two things. Know more. Last time I told you that subject I told you. The hope to which he has called you and me. We want to know about it. That's very important. God has a hope in his heart for you and me. That's why God sent you and me. That's why God gave you the gospel of truth. Everything he gave us. So we have salvation today and we can have a hope. And today, Paul, Apostle Paul, he's pray for that. To know something. We want to read this Bible 18 one more time. I pray that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people. Today I just want to give you this title, the riches of his glorious inheritance in his holy people. We have to know about this. I told you already, this is the 13th sermon of this Ephesians. Inheritance, is something father wants to give own children. It's a very important thing. Is God always give you something. You are very special. There are many children in the world, but my children is not much. I have 3 sons, you know that? That's why I can say that. Only 3 is mine, not all for me. That's why God wants to tell you, you are the children of our God. I want to think about just 3 things about this inheritance mean. Firstly, the glorious inheritance is about the land. God always telling us through the Bible many times over, he says something about land. I have no land in the world. I have no land. That's why I rent house. Yeah. Maybe you have the land. That's why you may understand more than me. God called Abraham at the first time from his own land. He was staying in Mesopotamia, far from the Canaan. It's really far. God called him, his father was a silversmith. That means he has out of the faith. He has no idea who is Jehovah, who is our God. But God called him and brought him out of that Mesopotamia, Chaldean. And he pointed him to Canaan. You have to go there. The land I want to give you, a particular land appointed. So he wants to put it there. There was promise to Abraham. And same like Israel people out of Egypt. Exodus was happened in the time. God called out from that country, Egypt. They were a slave. After that, he promised to the Israel people. Exodus 6:8 verse said, "And I will bring you into the land which I swore to give to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And I will give it to you as a heritage." Heritage means inheritance too. I am the Lord. In the Bible, everything is same way he wants to say. The point is very clear. There is a land we have to go back. It is Old Testament. New Testament, Jesus said. John chapter 14 verse 3 said, "There are many homes up there where my father lives, and I am going to prepare them for your coming." I'm going to prepare the land. We have to go back. What is land means? Land mean is country or nation. All nation or country, they have a rulers. There are many rulers in the world, the governors. They are always faithful to us. We can't satisfy for them. They are ruling. But God is our king. And he reigns over us. The country, that nation, God wants to build in our heart, has no fail. Will not fail. Our God is the only one can rule over us. Amen. That country is coming. We have to go back. He's going to prepare for us. So we have to go back there. The country, the kingdom of God is not for every people. Only the people was saved by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ can enter that place. So it is honor for us. It will be a glory. Amen. When Israel people, the country was destroyed. And after that, there was prisoner. When they came back from foreign country, the people, they can't forget about the glory in that time. Psalm 126 verse 1 to 3. When the Lord brought back to the captivity of Zion, we were like those who dream. Then our mouth was filled with laughter and our tongues with singing. Then they said among the nation, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, and we are glad. Imagine that their country was taken by the foreign people. It's a long time. And after that old people, they have a chance to come back there to their own land. And that time, that people reminded the glory of the kingdom of God and Solomon and David. That kingdom was reminded. And after that, they full of their eyes of the tears, and they said, "Ah, we are so happy to come back to our country." That is the glory. That moment, we can't feel it, but we can think about that thing. There will be a glorious for them. That country, that nation, God wants to build in our heart. Sometime we have to go back. God, Jesus, He prepared for us someday. That's why at the time, maybe we can go there with our eyes full of the tears. Send laughter in my mouth and singing and dancing. Jesus is coming, amen. Jesus is coming for us and bring us to the land that He promised us, amen. We thank for God, the glorious inheritance in His holy people. I told you that the first meaning of about the land. Second, I want to tell you, this glorious inheritance is about the people of God. People. People is like you and me. People means saved one, saved people. I know that you have salvation, right? Because you believe Jesus Christ in your heart, accept Jesus in your heart. That means you became a children of God by the Holy Spirit. So you and me, our church members, are all the people of God today, under His reign, under His authority. We are belong here in this country, Fiji, but we know that our country, our nation, is up here above all things. Amen. So we are the people of God. Deuteronomy chapter 4 verse 20 said, "But the Lord has taken you and brought you out of the iron furnace out of Egypt to be His people, an inheritance as you are this day." What is He saying? Inheritance, His people, as you are today. Amen. Inheritance is the people of God. Chapter 9 verse 29 also said, "But they are your people, your inheritance." In the Bible said, the people is inheritance that you brought out by your great power and your outstretched arm. Chapter 32 verse 9 said, "For the Lord's portion is His people." Jacob is allotted inheritance. Jacob is Israel. Yeah. The people of God. The meaning. Psalm 33 verse 12 is said, "Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord, the people He chose for His inheritance." Amen. There is no nation, only a nation. Nation always have a people. Because we are the people of God. That's why we are all inheritance of God. If you want to know about the riches of His glorious inheritance, you want to know about it, then we have to know who we are, who we were. We have to know first who we were before our salvation. Without God, we are nothing. Amen. Without Jesus, this sacrifice for us, we are just found ourselves in sinner. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 1. Once you are dead because of your disobedience and your many sins, in the Bible said, once we were dead, now he's saved. Amen. I love this song, English song, Who Am I? Said, I am a flower quickly fading, here today and gone tomorrow, a wave tossed in the ocean, a vapor in the wind. Seal you, heal me when I'm calling, Lord, you catch me when I'm falling, and you told me who I am. I am yours. I am a flower quickly fading away. Today is beautiful, but tomorrow is gone. Wave, like a wave in the ocean, is toasted. They're gone away. It's like a rolling sound is coming and bump and toasted. They're gone away. We are the vapor, something like a smoke before the wind, just one is gone away. Our life is just like that. Without God, we are nothing. You can think about, maybe many people say that I can living 100 years. Many people say that. Life is just like the air. Time is very fast. I remember when I was a teenager in a school, it looks like I can be everything in the world, that the arrogant in my mind. But now, in the middle of 40, yes, my body is a little bit have a misfunctioning now. Yeah, my eye is dark, so I have to wear the glass now. Time is very fast. Our life is not much longer. It's coming. We have to think about who we are, who we were. We were sinners, we were nothing. Just before Jesus found me, our God found me in grace. Amen. By the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, freely given us this grace, this salvation, we became a children of God. We became the people of God today. We have full of grace right now, full of the glory in our life, the kingdom of God and his people. We were chosen for his inheritance. Amen. We are his inheritance. Amen. Lastly, I just want to tell you about this glorious inheritance. Me, it's all about me. I just read this one Bible today. Matthew chapter 6 verse 28 verse 9. Yet King Solomon in all his glory was not clothed as beautifully as they. What is that? Jesus said, look at that flowers on the ground. Look at that lilies, it is beautiful. Why you worry a lot? Even the Solomon, you know, that king is very great king. So he has many things. He has a lot of food and he has the beautiful cloth he wear all the time. But that glory is worse than a small flower on the ground. I was thinking about the flowers. What is that flower? The small. But his glory is bigger than Solomon's wear. What is meaning? The flower is just a flower, but is gloriously made it by God. He designed by purpose. He has to be there because God planned it. Amen? Same like that. You and me has a purpose. That's why God appointed and send you in the same place, in Fiji, in your house. God has a purpose all the time. God has a plan. God made you like this. God needs you in the world. what he has done, that the flowers has done. Nothing, just exist. And what you and me has to do. You are doing, going to work and come back to home and they're tired. And come to home and do something. And you go to field and take care of the children. And even washing your dishes. Everything what you have done is important before the Lord. Amen. God sent you in that exact point because God needed it. That thing is very glorious thing. Glorious inheritance in the world. Someday you can go off everything and you can go our place. God prepared for us. God needs you. That's why you send this Lomawai church. And we participate of our older thing of the church. We need to do that. God has a plan a lot. That's why God made me like this. And sent me here 13 years ago. God had a plan. That's why God sent me and Pastor Munish to that Lomawai in the small house. We start to worship together, a few people. But now God built our church here. Everything what we have to do with our hands is glorious things. God wants to make us do that things. Amen. Like that flowers. It has a purpose. It has a plan. It has a reason. That's why we can say that it's beautiful. It is glorious. But I tell you, it is important. You and me is the inheritance of our God. Before salvation came to my life, we were just very dirty by the sin. We lost our glory. God created like this. We were dumped it and trampled, stepped it out like a flower. But Jesus died on the cross for me and paid for everything. So our glory was recovered. We restored. We can have it again, that glorious inheritance again. We are just like that before our God. God created us like this. That's why we are more precious and worthy before the Lord. Amen. Even a small flower, we are more precious and glorious and noble than a small flower. Because I myself is the inheritance of our God. Amen. That's why Paul is praying like this. I want to pray about this, the spirit of wisdom and revelation God gave us, so we can know our God better and better all the time. And I pray again, enlighten your heart, open your eyes, so you understand about the hope of the call. And today, to know the riches of His glorious inheritance, I want to pray like this. Our church member, Lomawai, you know our God every day better and better. And open your eyes so you can see something very clear, to know the reason God called you. That is the hope of our God. Amen. And also God let you know that the riches of His glorious inheritance is promised the land. God wants to bring us back to that own land, salvation. We have done everything for this life, and God prepares something for us. He prepared that place. God reigns over us. He's the ruler, never fail for us. And also, we are the people of God. And I, myself, you yourself, is the precious in his sight, our God's sight, and gloriously God made us. original plan, original reason, we have to be glorify Him. Amen. We are the inheritance of our God. We want to know about it. Amen. I pray for this. Let's pray together. Our Heavenly Father, thank you so much. Please give a spirit of wisdom and revelations. Know about you more and more. And also I want to pray to know the hope of the call, the reason you called us. And also, let us know. Let every people know. Let our church members know the riches of glorious inheritance in our life. We are the people of God. We are, myself, is the glorious people, glorious and precious before the Lord. We want to know that. Thank you so much today, the word of God you can give us. So every time we just want to know about you more and more, our church members grow up, and so we can be mature the amount of the glory. Thank you so much. We give you glory and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest and abide each and every one of us forever and ever. Amen.